What's going on, everyone? It's Nantel's Commander here with Pokemon Battle Zone, and this is episode 9. Going off against 3 trainers in this video because I haven't done one of these in a little while, so decided to put 3 battles into one video. So I lead off with my Heatran, and he's got an Excavalier, and he switches out straight into his Rotom Heat form, obviously predicting the incoming fire type attack, and he was correct. Since I can't really do much to that thing because I'm Choice Scarfed, I might as well go out into my Aerodactyl. Pretty sure Aerodactyl is going to die here because whatever special move he throws out is most likely going to knock me out as a result, because, well, Aerodactyl can't take special moves that well, unfortunately, but it's a lot better on defense, so I guess that does balance it out. Plus, he gets a Mega this generation. So he goes out into his Excavalier, and I go back into my Heatran. He's going to switch out, and I actually didn't think he would go out into the Rotom Heat form again, but I went for Earth Power anyway, and I actually, I don't think I was aware that it got Levitate, which is probably a bit of a silly thing on my part, because I really should know how to do that, but sorry about that. And I go out into my Weavile, and he goes for the Thunder, but it's going to miss, so that's good for me. He seems to be faster than me, I think, or is it because he switched? Actually, because I switched. So I go out into, I go for the Night Slash onto the Excavalier, and because Steel is now neutral, when hit by Tark-type moves, it's going to do neutral damage. I do get the critical hit, so that's actually very helpful for me. And he's going to go out into his Togekiss, so I thought, well, Poison Jab is the best choice I've got here. It's probably not going to KO because it is a Togekiss after all. But on the bright side, I do get the poison, so that's really good for me. And I do lose some life because of the Life Orb, and this is definitely going to kill me due to the fact, well, Weavile's defenses, need I say more. So Weavile goes down and he takes some poison damage. Doesn't really matter in the long run since I'm pretty sure Heatran's going to knock it out with a flamethrower at this point. And his last Pokemon is obviously a Rotom Heat form. And I figured, well, even if I do lose my Heatran, I do still have one more Pokemon in the boot. So just keep going for flamethrower and that'll be that. So it's going to do decent damage. It will eventually knock it out, and he goes for the overheat. I'm thinking, what? Overheat? Either that was a misclick, or he ended up, or it was just forgot about flash fire. So as a result, he actually forfeits, and we're now going into the next battle. He leads off with a shiny Sableye, which actually looks pretty sweet. That actually looks pretty cool. So he's got Prankster. I think he's got Prankster, and you know, he's going to go for the taunt. It doesn't really matter because I'm actually an Assault Vest Suicune and I go straight for the Scald. So the taunt was actually meaningless. And he goes out into his shiny Gardevoir. This guy seems to like his shinies. I'm guessing they were sent from the 5th generation and maybe they were Pokégens, but I don't really care. So I go for the Scald, and I fortunately do get the Burn, which is of course nice for me. Although it doesn't really matter in the long run because he's going to go for Psychic, but I'm a Salt Vest Swampert. That's still not going to be not enough to even knock off half of my HP. So I go for the Earthquake and knock that thing out. So my taunt wears off, even though it doesn't matter in the slightest. He goes out into Charizard, and, well, let's just say, I don't know why you did this, because, you know, he obviously doesn't know that I have Stone Edge, so why did you send this thing out? I guess, I don't know. I mean, I'm a water type as it is. I don't know why he did that. But I guess he didn't think Sableye would cut it, and he was hoping he might get away with the Solar Beam. But he actually does forfeit that match, so he's also getting another win. And next trainer. So they are leading off with a Slurpuff. Another shiny. What's with the shinies today? There seems to be a lot of shiny Pokemon. So I lead off with my Sceptile because, well, Sceptile is awesome. This isn't the same Sceptile from my PBR videos, but I probably will bring that one across because, let's face it, this one isn't actually as good as that one because it doesn't have Dragon Pulse and it's got Hidden Power Bug, which isn't exactly nice, and I recently learned for this battle that Fairy actually resists Bug, so that's something I learned for this battle. So he's going to go for the belly drum, apparently, and that's actually quite interesting. So he's combining the wish with the belly drum, which is a bit of a risky move, but it actually does work out. So I'm going to go straight for the leaf storm here, because it's the best option I've got on this Slowpuff. It does a good amount of damage to it, and he's going to go for play rough. Fortunately, I am protected by my substitute, and well, I will lose it. It is definitely going to help me out. So I switch out because, well, he's going to go for Play Wolf most likely, and Heatran, if with a plus 6 attack, Heatran is still going to take that pretty nicely. But he turns out to go for the Wish again, which was a bit risky, I suppose, because I could have gone for another Leaf Storm, but whatever. So I'm going to go for the Flamethrower. That's definitely going to outspeed, and it's definitely going to knock it out, because, well, Slowpuff is decent, I guess. So he goes out to his Mawile, and obviously this is a Mega Mawile. Intimidate does not matter in the slightest because, well, I'm a special attacker. So go for the Mega Evolution with Mawile, and I'm predicting a Sucker Punch because, well, that's just what Mawile seems to do these days. And I go for Flamethrower. That's most likely going to knock it out because, well, I'm a Heatran. And Mawile's defenses, they are pretty good, but I don't know what the EV spread for that thing is. Now, this Volcarona could prove to be a bit annoying because, well, Flamethrower, as you can see, is doing a decent amount of damage, but it has access to that Quiver Dance, which isn't exactly helpful to me. So all I can hope for here is either it doesn't do enough damage to knock me out, or I get a critical hit with Flamethrower. But I do still have my other two guys in the boot, do I? I think I still have both my Pokemon. So anyway, he's going to go for the Roost. So I'm guessing his attacking set, obviously he has Bug Buzz, and he's got probably Flamethrower maybe, or Fire Blast. Obviously the Fire type move is useless because, well, I'm a Heatran, and Bug Buzz isn't much good either because I'm 4 times resistant to the Bug Buzz. So as a result, I don't know what he can do to me, but it doesn't matter because I get a critical hit with the Flamethrower, and that results in the video. So thank you very much for watching, my honourable viewer. I hope you enjoyed it, and there'll be another one of these going up probably tomorrow or a couple of days from now. So hope you look forward to that. This is Dantos Commander. I'll see you guys later. Thanks for watching.